Hello, welcome to Sports Talk. We are outside the Shaw Cable Systems location here in Central Alberta. Hugh, why am I outside doing Sports Talk? It is freezing out here.
Yes, but we had a bet, and if the Bombers won, then we were going to be inside normal, and you would be, you know, singing the praises of the Bombers. And
I don't know, this outside. Is what I don't understand for our viewers, is that I win the bet, and I still have to be outside. Why shouldn't I be inside, and you be outside, and we have a dual screen here? Because I'm freezing.
Well, our technology doesn't really add for a dual
unbelievable.
Screen. And it's in your contract.
Yes, we're talking Grey Cup. A fairly good game. I don't think I would go as far to say a great
classic,
game.
No.
It wasn't a classic. I think there's been better Grey Cups in recent memory. But this was a good game. What went wrong for the Winnipeg Blue Bombers?
First off, they started off the game and they were, you know, in a state of I don't know what, because they were just running around and they didn't know what they were doing. And then the Lions got 11 quick points. That hurt the Bombers off the top, the 11 quick points. The offense sputtered right off the top, and they got away from the run game. Yeah, I know a lot of people are going to say, well, their running game wasn't working on first down. Well, yeah, it wasn't working on first down, but they didn't try it on second down. And the problem is that they went two and out either way. So if you're going to go two and out with the run that got you there, then, you know, you do that for the first half, it doesn't work, let's put the ball in Buck's hands. Buck wasn't ready for the ball to be in his hands.
And Buck, I thought, played okay. He didn't play great. It's kind of like the game itself. He played good, but not great. He didn't make the team better. He didn't win this game.
But I don't think he lost the game. What did you say before the game started?
Well, I don't remember. I said a lot of things. I said
about Buck Pierce in order for the Bombers to win.
I said Buck Pierce, you know what? Buck Pierce is mediocre. He's not a winner.
I think I said.
What did I say? I said a lot of things.
I said he was mediocre. Game of his life in order for
I didn't say that too. Yeah. I didn't say that.
Game of his life, right?
So. I do believe that Buck Pierce had to have the game of his life to win that game. And is he mediocre? Yes. Did he do enough to win that game? I don't think so. One thing that I thought following the Twitter feed, of course you can follow us here at Shaw TV Red Deer, is people were complaining that interception or non-interception, and we've talked about this off camera. I thought, I mean, this happened in the first half.
Early.
I thought it was an interception. You still think it, you don't think it was, but my beef with this, and this is not my beef of the week, but my beef, you know what, if fans are blaming the loss on that maybe blown call by the refs, the Bombers didn't deserve to win anyways, because
no.
You know what? Yes, I thought that was the interception, but I also thought if they had called it incomplete, it would not have remained as it would have remained as an incomplete pass. I think either way, whatever the original call was, it had to stay there.
I'm gonna take this off to another level of the game. For you, I'm gonna let you go first.
Yes.
And you probably take what I'm gonna take. But what is your turning point of the game? Turning point. Was it a kickoff? What's the turning point of the game for you?
You know, I think the turning point actually, I don't have a specific turning point necessarily. Maybe you could go to the Paris Jackson push off at the catch in the sidelines, Arlan Bruce. I think the turning point actually would be the Winnipeg offense at the end of the first half not being able to score a touchdown. If they score a touchdown with the BC Place crowd completely out of it, they were out of this game, and they had a chance to take advantage of that, and they didn't. And I don't have a specific turning point. I think the turning point is just in general the Winnipeg offense not being able to score a touchdown when it mattered. I mean, Paul McCallum misses a field goal and they don't take advantage. And that's where I think it comes down to, is that Buck Pierce, Chris Garrett could not get the job done offensively. Full props to Wally Bono and the BC Lions, though.
Yeah, the BC Lions played a good game. They played their game, but they weren't the dominant team mm-hmm. that everybody was expecting to see. And I'm telling you, they're not as dominant as when they played the Eskimos looked terrible.
Yep.
I mean, they looked
yep.
like out of sorts. They didn't even know which way it was up. But I'll say, for me, the turning point was when Willis didn't make that interception.
Yep.
He makes that interception. The game was, I think, 17-6 at the
yep.
time.
Yep.
He makes that interception. We got a game. We got
yep.
a game. And, you know, you're a star player. You haven't really done anything in the last, I don't know, 3 or 4 weeks. This is your time to step up. You have the ball thrown to you by Travis Lule. I mean, thrown to
yep.
you right there. He doesn't make the catch.
I mean, the kickoff, it's not a turning point, but the kickoff was a big deal. The onside kick at the end of the game.
That was a huge, huge deal.
You kick it 6.5 yards. Like, come on, man. What is your job? So.
And that was in the air.
And it arced. I mean, it's a good U-turn. It's good. Good. Maybe driving school should take that. And this is how you do a U-turn. Turn around from the line there.
There's no wind in the dome. What?
Pathetic. Congratulations, though, to Wally Buono. Let's move on to some NHL news quickly. Bruce Boudreau gets fired, not surprisingly. Paul Maurice gets fired. not surprisingly. Are these good moves for these teams? Now, Kirk Muller is now the coach of the Carolina Hurricanes. Dale Hunter is now the coach of the Washington Capitals. The one thing that I wanted to say is that Kirk Muller was the coach for the AHL team for Nashville. They could have prevented Carolina to talk to him. They said, no, go ahead. I just wanted to say props to the Nashville Predators for being kind of a class organization, for allowing a guy to finally get the opportunity to get his chance at coaching.
Yeah, that's a good thing. I think, first of all, I think Boudreau had to go. You can't sit Malkin. You can't sit Ovechkin. Got my Russians all mixed up. You can't sit Ovechkin at the end of the game. Ovechkin, after that point, he had lost Ovechkin, and Ovechkin is not going to play for you. And you know what? If you lose Ovechkin, you're gone. You may have won the win.
What happens if Ovechkin doesn't do anything now, though? What happens if he keeps underperforming? What next?
Well, then they're going to have to find another coach that he's going to perform under. You don't get rid of Alexander Ovechkin. He's the grade eight.
And Carolina, I like this move actually for Carolina. I don't know about Paul Maurice. I don't think he's a great coach. I think he's a good coach.
He's a good coach.
Already being rumored to go to Columbus, actually. Yeah. That's how good of a coach he is.
And you're Blockbuster? What do you say?
Well,
I
thought Randy Carlyle would be let go as well today. That might come by the end of the week. So let's move on now, Hugh. It's time for our beef of the week. I'm going to start off to all those haters in Twitter land that were ripping on Nickelback. Yeah, I get it. You hate Nickelback. I get it. I still want to say this, though. They are better than the Black Eyed Peas were last year in Super Bowl, the halftime show there. So you know what? Just keep your opinions to yourself, because you know what? Nickelback, probably the greatest Canadian band ever. Get used to it.
Can I say 100,000 times better than Black Eyed Peas at the Super Bowl or at the Grey Cup?
I can't. So that's where it's like, this is your best band to have perform at Grey Cup.
Yeah.
You want Blue Rodeo to come back again and have him burp on stage? I don't. I'd rather see Chad Kroeger.
Depends on how long the burp was. Okay, my beef of the week, many people will not agree with me, but my beef
is the
calls at BC Place tend to always go for the BC Lions, and I've seen two push-offs in the last two games. Arlan Bruce pushed off, and I'm getting a little dirt kicked on me here, but I saw Arlan Bruce.
I can't argue the beefs. It's unbelievable.
He pushed off, and now Paris Jackson with the push-off and no call, and I seen pushes. It was like that. That's the push-off, and that is the classic call in the games. But they use that as video to say, hey, this is what a push-off looks like. Paris Jackson did it, got away with it. Did it make a difference in the game? No. But I'm saying that you got to make these calls. That's my beef.
That's it for Sports Talk. It's you. I'm Chris. That's it for Sports Talk. You can email us at sportstalk@shaw.ca. We'll see you next time.